sum to n terms, isn't it? Sum to n terms. Sum to n terms. What is the formula we learned? Diya, sum to n terms of a GP is given by
a into 1 minus r raised to n by 1 minus r if r is smaller than 1.
A into 1 minus r raised to n by 1 minus r. If r is greater than, correct, good. And what is the next formula we have learned? If r is greater than 1, Annette? On a tangent, the second formula.
A into Rn minus 1 by R minus 1.
It's R raised to n, okay? R raised to n. A into, it's correct, formula is correct. A into R raised to n minus 1 by R minus 1 if the common ratio is greater than 1. Okay? So in that last question we discussed, is it clear? We discussed one question in the last one, that is sum up to 5 plus 55 plus and so on. That question we discussed, that one is an important question. Okay, we are going to learn similar question now. We are going to discuss similar question. Okay, read the question. Read the question. Find the sum of the following series. 0.7 plus 0.77 plus 0.77 plus etc. up to n terms. Up to n terms. So in the last class, we discussed about 5 plus 55 plus 555. I think this is the question we discussed in the class, isn't it? Let's recall the steps what we did. What is the first step we did? First step is?
Multiply and divide by 1 by n.
No, before that we did one thing. We took the common number outside. We took 5 outside. That's the first step. You take the common number out. Okay. So we are taking 5 outside. Then second step is what Punya said, that is correct. What is the second step? Multiply and divide by 9. Okay, the same procedure only here also we are going to do. First step is, the question is Sn is equal to, we are denoting it as Sn. Sn means sum to n terms. 0.7 plus 0.77 plus 0.777 plus etc. up to n terms. Okay, so I am taking the 7, the common number outside. If you take the common number outside, you will get 0.1. plus 0.11 plus 0.111 plus and so on up to n terms. What is the next step? Multiply and divide it by 9. Procedure is same, the same method what we did in the previous one. Multiply by 9. When you multiply by 9, it is 0.9 plus 0.99. plus 0.999 plus and so on up to n terms. So this is equivalent to 7 by 9 into. Okay, 0.9.
Ma'am, from where 9 come?
Okay, in this model when we want, okay, if you convert this in 9, okay, if you convert this in 9, 9 we can easily simplify as 10 minus 1. 99 means we can write in, it is closer to 10. We can make it to the powers of 10. But making that, we are multiplying and dividing it by 9.
Okay.
0.9 means we can write this as, shall I write this as 9 by 10? Is it correct? 9 by 10 means, is it 0.9?
Yes, ma'am.
Plus 0.99. We can write this as 99 by 100. Is it correct? plus 0.99 means 999 by
999,000
plus etc. Okay, up to n terms. Okay, this is same as 7/9. Now listen, all of you listen here. This 9/10 we can write this as 1 - 1/10. Is it correct? Is it 1 - 1/10? You take the LCM here. 10 - 1 is it 9/10?
Yes, ma'am.
Like this, 99/10 we can write this as
1 - 1/100.
1/100. 1 - 1/100. Very good. Plus, what about the next one?
1 - 1/1,000.
1/1,000. Is it clear, children? Up to n terms. We are multiplying it by 9 because 9 is closer to 10. 99 is closer to 1,000 to make it the powers of 10. Okay. So now group the terms like what we did in the previous question. I'm grouping all the terms. 1, 1, 1, 1. We are writing it n times. So 1 + 1 + etc. up to 1. N times we are adding. Then the remaining terms, the powers of 10. 1/10. -1/100, -1/1,000, and so on. This is also up to n terms. This is up to n terms. So this is same as 1. If we add n times, 1 + 1 + 1, if you add n times, we will get n. Then from the remaining terms, I am taking minus as common. If you take minus as common, we will get 1/10 plus 1/100 means we can write this as 1/10² plus 1/1,000 means we can write this as 10³ plus and so on. The last term takes the form 1/10⁴. 7/9 is common. 7/9 is common outside. Is it okay? Is it clear, children? Now look at this part. Look at this part. This is a GP. Is it correct? Is it correct, Gauri? Is it correct? From here, can you give what is A and what is R?
0.7 is A.
0.7, which one? Look at the series here. Here, the GP is 1/10. Plus 1/10² So A is?
1/10.
A is 1/10. And the common ratio is also 1/10. A is 1/10 and common ratio is also 1/10. So you can apply the formula. Common ratio 1/10 means it is less than 1. Common ratio is less than 1. So we can write this as N. What is the formula for SN? SN is A into 1 - r⁴ / n/1 - r if the common ratio is less than 1. So on applying that formula, N minus A is 1/10. 1/10 into 1 - 1/10 / n/1 - 1/10. 1 - 1/10. Okay. Is it okay, children? So this is same as 7/9 × (n - 1/10) × (1 - 1/10⁴ n) / (1 - 1/10) means it is 1 - 1/10 means it is 9/10. Okay, this by is not there. Only for this term only you will get by. You know by, n minus. So here, this by 10 will get cancelled. Now, open the bracket. When you open the bracket, you will get 7/9 n - already one 9 is there. Okay. 7/9 n / 7/9 × 9, you will get 81 × (1 - 1/10) / n. Is it okay? Is it okay? If you want, you can take 1 7 by 9 as common, and you can write like this also. 1 by 9 into 1 minus 1 by 10 raised to n. Either you can stop with this, or you can multiply it inside, and you can write. Is it okay? Go through the steps again. Go through the steps. What we did, go through it. Okay, what we did here. Okay, so find the sum of the series. What we did here. SN is 0.7 plus 0.77 plus 0.77, and so on. What we did is, we take 7 as common. We take 7 as common. After taking 7 as common, we are getting 0.1, 0.11, 0.111, and so on. Next step, multiply and divide by 9. When you multiply by 9, 9 dividing by 9, we are keeping it outside. We are multiplying inside by 9. So 0.9 plus 0.99 plus 0.99, etc. up to n terms. That is same as 7 by 9 into 0.9. We can write this as 9 by 10. 0.99, we are writing it as 99 by 100. Next is 999 by 1000, plus and so on up to n terms. 9 by 10, we can write this as 1 minus 1 by 10. 99 by 100, we can write this as 1 minus 1 by 100. 999 by 1000 means it is 1 minus 1 by 1000, and so on. Next step, again we are grouping it. We are collecting all the terms with 1 to one side, and all the terms with powers of 10 to other sides. Okay. So when we group this 1, 1, 1, we are getting n times. So it is n minus, from all these terms you are taking minus outside, and we are writing 100,000 as powers of 10. 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10 square plus 1 by 10 cube plus etc. up to plus 1 by 10 raised to 10. So which is a GP. If you take this term, it is a geometric progression, with the first term 1 by 10 and common ratio is also 1 by 10. 1 by 10 means it is less than 1. Then we are applying the formula for SN, and we are simplifying. Is it okay? Is it okay? Similar model only yesterday we discussed. One question, 5 plus 55 and so on. Okay? Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Any doubt in this one? Okay,
ma'am, can you explain the last three steps?
Last three steps, okay. Last three steps, listen. We'll explain it. In the last three steps, what we are doing here. One second, I'll explain. Okay, so I'll explain it once again. Okay, now can you see this one?
Yes, ma'am.
So look at the last step. Look at the last step here. We are taking so from the last step, what we are doing, we are using the sum to n terms. 7 by 9 we are taking as common, and we are using the formula a into 1 minus r raised to n by 1 minus r. A into 1 minus r raised to n by 1 minus r, which is same as 7 by 9 into n minus 1 by 10 into 1 a by b whole raised to n, means we can write this as a raised to n by b raised to n. So 1 by 10 whole raised to n means we can write this as 1 raised to n by 10 raised to n, which is same as 1 by 10 raised to n by 1 minus 1 by 10. 1 minus 1 by 10, if you take the LCM, it is 10 minus 1, which is 9 by 10. Then again, by 10 will get cancelled. By 10 will get cancelled. So you will get 7 by 9 into n minus 7 by 81 into 1 minus 1 by 10 raised to n. If we want, we can take 1 7 by 9 as common and we can write this as n minus 1 by 9 into 1 minus 1 by 10 raised to n. Is it okay?
Yes.
You can stop with this. Or you can multiply this inside and you can write. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Look at the next one. Read the question. It's the next one. How many terms? How many terms of the GP 3, 3 by 2, 3, 3 by 2, 3 by 4, etc. are needed to give a sum. To give a sum. Sum is given as 3069 by 512. 3069 by 512. How many terms are needed? How many terms are needed means we have to find how many terms. That means what we have to find. Very good. N. You have to find N. So once a GP is given, you can write what is A and what is R. What's the value of A here? A is?
3.
3. And what is R? How will you find R? Second term by first term. A2 by A1. So R is?
1 by 2.
1 by 2. Now R is 1 by 2 means which is less than 1. So Sn, we can use the formula. Sn is equal to A into 1 minus R raised to N by 1 minus R. So Sn is given. So 3069 by 502. 512 is equal to A is given as 3. 3 into 1 minus 1 by 2 whole raised to N by 1 minus 1 by 2. And this one we have to simplify. On simplifying, what we will get? So this is same as, okay, this is same as 3069 by 512 is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 means it is again 1 by 2. This 2 will go to the numerator. So you can write this as 6 into 1 minus 1 by 2 whole raised to n. Is it correct? 1 minus half means it is half. This 2 will go to the numerator. Then this one you can simplify. You can divide it by 3. You divide it by 3. 1023. Here if you again divide it by 3. Simplify that one. So when you divide it by 3. 512. And you divide it by 3. Is it possible to divide it by 3? Hello? Is it possible?
No.
Yeah, no. Then what we can do, this 6 you bring it down. Okay, here this is divisible by 3, but this one is not divisible. So what I'm going to do, 3069 by 512, this is in product, you can take it to the denominator here, is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 whole raised to n. Now we can cancel this. Okay. So this 6, if you cancel by 3, this is 2 and this is 1023. Now again cut short it, simplify. Simplify this and find the powers of 2. Find the powers of 2. What is the power of 2 you are getting? Okay. So this one is simplified. Okay. Can you simplify this? Sn is given. From Sn, you are asked to find n. Sn is given as 3069 by 512. And you are asked to find n. Okay, you can simplify this and you can find what is the value of n. What is the value of n? Simplifying. So this, if you want the next step, you can write this as 1 by 2 whole raised to n is equal to 1023 by 512 into 12 means this is 421024 minus 1. Okay, minus 1 by 2 whole raised to n is 1023 plus 1 I am taking to other side, it will become minus 1. That is same as, if I take the LCM here, 1023 minus 1024 by 1024. So we will be getting minus 1 by 2 whole raised to n is equal to minus 1 by 1024. So this minus will get cancelled. So 1 by 2 raised to n is equal to 1 by 1024. 1024, you have to prime factorize it and you have to express in the powers of 2. Ten. 1 by 2 raised to n is, yes. What's the answer?
10.
10, 2 raised to 10. So on comparing, the value of n is 10. You compare it, the value of n we will get is 10. Okay. This is about sum to n terms. Sum to n terms. Okay. Okay. In AP, we learned about arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean of two numbers, A and B, is given by
A plus B by 2.
Very good. It is A plus B by 2. Likewise, here we are going to learn about geometric mean. Geometric mean of two numbers. Okay, suppose we are given two numbers, A and B. Okay, arithmetic mean of A and B is given by A plus B by 2. We are adding these two and divide it by 2. Geometric mean, we denote it as GM and it is denoted by root of AB. Multiply these two and take the root. Multiply these two numbers and take the root. For arithmetic progression, we are adding that two numbers and divide it by 2. For finding geometric mean, multiply A and B and take the square root. Okay, for example, can you find the geometric mean between the numbers 2 and 8? Between 5, what is the geometric mean between the numbers 2 and 8? How to find geometric mean is, you take the square root of product of these two numbers. Square root of 2 into 8. So square root of 16, which is same as 4.
4.
You are taking for positive numbers, okay, not for negative. So, 2, 4, 8. Look at this. When you write this geometric mean in between A and B, in the GP, are you getting a GP here? Between 2 and 8, I am inserting this GP. Geometric mean. Is it a GP? 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into 2 is 8. So, we can insert geometric means in between the given numbers. In AP, we have learned, suppose you are given a number, given two numbers A and B. Between A and B, we can insert n arithmetic means, A1, A2, etc. up to AN. We can insert n arithmetic means so that this A, A1, A2, etc. up to AN, B will be an arithmetic progression. That one will be an arithmetic progression. When we insert n terms, what will be the total number of terms in that progression? when we insert n, arithmetic means in between a and b.
n plus 2,
isn't it? Total, we are inserting n terms, already a and b are there. So total number of terms in the progression is n plus 2. Same thing here also we can do. We suppose you are given a and b. Between a and b, we can insert n geometric means. g1, g2, etc. up to gn. So that a, g1, g2, etc. up to b is a geometric progression. We can insert n geometric means between a and b. So that a, g1, g2, etc. up to b is a geometric progression. Look at here, we inserted one geometric mean here. And look at, is it a geometric progression? Is the common ratio same? 4 divided by 2, the ratio is 2. 8 divided by 4, the ratio is 2. Okay, so common ratio is same. So we can insert n terms in between the given terms. So that the resulting is a geometric progression. Is it okay? The geometric mean of two numbers is given by root of AB. So if two numbers A and B are given, their arithmetic mean AM, it is denoted by capital letter AM. It is given by A plus B by 2. And what about the geometric mean, Karthik? Geometric mean?
Root AB.
It is given by root AB. Okay, it is given by root AB. Okay. So next, let's do one question finding the geometric mean. Okay, let's find the geometric mean of the next numbers. Okay. So, okay, the geometric mean of two positive numbers, A and B, is the number root AB. Okay, suppose you are given two numbers A and B, their geometric mean is given by root AB. Given two positive integers A and B, we can insert n numbers, g1, g2, etc. up to gn, between A and B, so that when we insert n geometric means in between A and B, it will become a geometric progression. So when we insert n terms, total number of terms will become an plus 2. An plus 2 is b. So when you apply the formula, nth term formula, ar raised to n minus n plus 1 is b. Is it correct? Nth term is given by ar raised to n. So a into r raised to n plus 1 is b. So what is the ratio here? R plus 1 is b by a. Okay. From here you can find the ratio also. Ratio is given by b by a whole raised to 1 by n plus 1. Nth root we can take. Okay, we can discuss about this more in the next class. You can stop with this, time up. So recall all the formulas what we have learned today. Okay. Can learn more about more properties of geometric progression in the next class. Thank you. Can wind up.